There is a new solution on my website. This menu allows us to select a character, and then when we press this button, it loads a game scene with the chosen character. In the corner, you have a link to the article where you can download this solution and find more information about how it works. When you import the package, the first thing to do is to add the scenes to the compilation. Having the menu scene open, go to File, Field Settings, and press Add Open Scene. Then open the second scene and press the button one more time. If you skip this step, pressing the play button won't load the game scene. The explanation of this solution is gonna be split in two parts. We are gonna talk about how the system works here in Unity, that is, taking into account the hierarchy, the objects, and the scripts in the inspector. And in the second part, we are gonna see these two scripts. Character selection menu is the one that controls the selection menu, and game control is in charge of the game scene. So let's begin with the menu scene. We have a canvas with three buttons. Here the next and previous buttons allow us to navigate between the characters, and the green button loads the game scene. We also have all the available characters placed in advance. This could be done in different ways. For example, if the characters were not predefined, we can take the prefabs and instantiate them through code. Something like that I do in the other scene. This game object has the menu control script assigned, character selection menu. Here in the public fields, we see an array called player objects where the character references are gonna be assigned. If you want to add more characters, what you have to do is to place them here in the position in the hierarchy, increase the size of the array. For example, if you have 5 characters, the size must be 5, and then drag the characters to the new spaces. And with that, the system would continue working, at least here in the character selection menu. Then you have to do something similar in the game scene. Then we have an index, selected character. This is the index that will allow us to access each element of the array. For example, here is 0. With this, we can point to the element 0 of the array, that is the dinosaur. And this string is the name of the scene that will be loaded when pressing the green button. Now, let's get into game mode and see what happens in Inspector with this system. Note that here all the characters are active. When you press play, all but one of them are disabled. The index is 2, so we're pointing to the element 2 of the array. When pressing these buttons, the index changes. If we press this button, the index will decrease from 2 to 1, and that way it will point to this other character. While with this button, the index will increase, in this case, from 0 to 1. Here we must take into account that this index can only point to valid elements of the array. Note that here we have 3 elements, the first element has an index of 0, and the last element has an index of 2, or the size of the array minus 1. So, if we have an index of 2 and we increase that value, we cannot allow the index to be 3, because if we try to access an element of the array that doesn't exist, it will give us a runtime error. So, when increasing the index, we have to check if we exceed the maximum allowed size, and in that case, make the index return to 0. For this reason, when the index is 2 and we move to the next character, the index changes to 0. And if the index has a value of 0 and we press the previous button, the new index value would be minus 1. But that would not be pointing to a valid object of the array, so we have to check that situation and make the new index equals to the size of the array minus 1. That is, from 0, when pressing the previous button, the index would change to 2. So, when we press the previous or the next button, all this happens. The first thing that is done is to turn off the currently selected character, for example this dinosaur. When we press any of the buttons, this character will be disabled. Then the index will be modified, and then the character that the index is pointing to will be activated. That's all that happens when we press the next or the previous button. When you press the play button, two things happen. The first is that we will save this value in memory if we are on a computer, or in the internal memory if we are on a mobile device. And this will allow us to read that index in the other scene and place the character that was selected in this menu scene. Now, let's see how the game scene works. First, we have this button that allows us to return to the main menu. Then we have this object called game control that has a script with the same name assigned, game control. And this is the one that is in charge of placing the character that was chosen in the menu scene. An important detail is that this is the same array as the one in the main menu, with a different name, but essentially the same. It has the same size and has the characters in the same order. The order is important because otherwise it will not appear the right character. So if we want to add new characters, what we have to do is to modify this array both in the main menu and here in the game scene. This is a little uncomfortable, and of course it's not the best way to do it, but it's a simple way to understand it and to begin with, especially if we only have a few characters. Here we have the position where the character is gonna appear. It's simply a game object that is located at some point on the scene. Then we have the name of the scene that is gonna be loaded when we press the back button or the escape key. And finally, we have this object that is empty, but when we start the game, it's gonna have the reference of the instantiated character. An important difference from the menu scene is that here the characters are not initially in the scene. These references are not pointing to some element in the hierarchy, but they are pointing to a prefab, that is the character's object here in the assets folder. When we start this scene, what will happen is that one of these prefabs will be instantiated in the indicated position. This is another way to place the characters. You may have used exactly the same way in the menu and in this scene. I decided to do it this way to show you another alternative. So that would be all for this video. In the next part, we will see how these scripts work. See you there.